So I just watched UFC 202, and I must say that it was an exciting fight, although a really bad fight. Nate Diaz looked like he was inebriated from the start, and as soon as Connor landed a kick on Nate's leg, Joe Rogan immediately harped about vicious leg kicks. It sounded suspicious as fuck, if you ask me. Granted, Nate's movement was terrible the whole fight, and he was a bloody mess by getting tagged by McGregor early. In the third round he started to bully McGregor and pin him against the cage for the rest of the fight. I honestly don't see where McGregor had any claim on rounds 3 through 5, due to the fact of his getting punched and slapped while being in the clinch. Diaz definitely landed more than McGregor in those rounds. I figured that if it got to a decision it would be a wash for McGregor, and I guess I was right. It was a majority decision, with one judge somehow calling it a draw. As far as I'm concerned, despite Nate looking like a drunk the whole fight, and even getting knocked down like 3 or 4 times, he was not really getting hurt. He was just clumsy. If they fought to the death I would go with Nate, simply because he continued to pin Conor McMack. Turn. Against the cage, and wailed on him in the clinch. Conor was clearly a spent force in the end, and was finally taken down in round 5. With more time, Nate would have gotten a sub, and you know this, man. Anyway, the fight is over, and a third fight is undoubtedly going to happen, provided that Nate doesn't get busted for weed in his system. Well, all in all, I give UFC 202 maybe 6 stars out of 10. Cerrone is a beast, and Rumble Johnson looks ferocious as well, but overall I just felt underwhelmed by the whole event, once the anxious first moments of the main event sunk in. Well, that's all. Be sure to like, and only like this vid. Comment. Subscribe. And share. Bye now.